G'day, welcome back to Buildsum. So we've finally got this sheet done. We've done all our items for our concreter, and we've got a total price down the bottom here of $6,100. Now, if you're doing a full-size job, obviously you're going to have a lot of trades. You're going to have excavation, concreter, bricklayer, electrician to a point, all these other trades you've got to work out or estimate for. So we want to put that all that information into one sheet. So we're going to add a summary sheet at the start of this. So to add a new sheet or a new page, come down the bottom here near your tab for concreter, and you're just going to select the add sheet option. Okay, and that'll put in a new sheet. If you double click on that quickly, or right click and go rename, you can rename that to summary. Okay, and I like my summary sheet to be at the start. So you can actually click on that tab and just move it up to the start of the sheet. Okay, so then we can put a bit of a title on this. So let's just call this job the Buildsum. Oh, let's do it in capitals. Estimate summary. And you guys can import letterheads or do whatever you like in there. We can make that a little bit bigger in font. And we can make it bold and italic, whatever we want to do with it. Okay, we can spread that out over a few cells. Oh, not working for me. Or I can move it that way. Okay, so what I'm going to do then is down the side here, and actually move that cell over there. I'm just going to label these. So I'll space this out so it looks all right. So one, number one here. And as I was saying earlier, if you just use this little grab handle, and if I drag that now, I'm just going to get ones. Okay. But if I put two in there, select them both, and then drag, it will actually fill it out for me with the numbers I want, okay? That's a handy little function. So let's say trade number one was our excavation, and then trade two is gonna be a concreter. Trade three could be a carpenter. Right, and then you could have a bricklayer. Okay, you get the idea. You can list your trades down there. So for the concreter, I want to get the total amount that that's going to cost for that job. So what I'll do, similar to what we've done before, just hit the equals sign. Go to your tab for the concreter, select that tab, go to the cell that's got the total in it, and just select that. And you'll notice up here, it's actually said now that I'm reading the concreter sheet and N70, so N70. Just hit enter, and it'll take you back to the summary sheet, and there you'll have the total from your concreter sheet on your summary. And then down the bottom here, we can select and get a total. So this will give us a total for the whole job. Select that cell there. Sum. Select all these cells. And hit enter. And that will give us a total there. And I'll make that Australian dollars. Okay. So as I said, the reason why I set this up, if I go back to concreter, and I go back to that really simple little mistake I made at the start, and I say, okay, our slab is now 110mm thick, 110mm thick, it translates right through the sheet. So this has gone back to, well, this has gone back to 14.065, it's rounded up to 15, times by 300 gives us $4,000. Plus our whatever for our second item gives us our 5,500. And then if we go back to our summary sheet, our 5,500's come up there. So this is why I love doing this sort of stuff in Excel, because you can make the one little change and it will translate and save you a heap of time in calculations. So I hope that video and the rest help you work your way through sheets and Excel. G'day, I'm back. Just to let you know that if you like this video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel, or you can follow me on Facebook so you don't miss out on more great videos.